What's up, YouTube fans? Today, we're going to be unboxing the X-Transbots Commander Stack, their version of a Masterpiece Ultra Magnus. So I'm actually really excited to take a look at this. I've heard some really good things. I've also heard some things to watch out for, too, but I want to see this for myself. I did purchase a copy from the Chosen Prime. It's not quite in stock yet, so my friend Dr. Diecast was nice enough to send me his copy. What a guy to be able to just, he didn't even get a chance to play with it. He just sent it right off to me. So I appreciate that. Thank you again, Dr. Diecast. On the front of the box, you get this beautiful artwork. I love this artwork. This is just very well done. Looks like Autobot City, and there's a battle going on, and you got the Commander Stack figure there. On the side, you get some line work and the saying, which I'll read on the other side of the box, and then more artwork. Here's that space sort of scene we've seen. I don't see any new figures in this artwork. There's some of the G2 recolors in there. That one there, you got Senator Crosscut there, Cosmos. So there are some of their recolors here, but overall I don't see any brand new figures being revealed. But that's another nice piece of artwork there. And then on this side you have the saying, "Thirst for victory leads to defeat. Not firing of defeat leads to victory. Not tiring of defeat leads to victory." They always have these funny sayings. So let's get this open. And it does come in the traditional clamshell style packaging. So let's get this stuff out since it's already out. Looks like we get two replacement translucent eyes. I'm not sure why we get two. Might be different expressions. So we'll take a look at that. You get this minifigure, which is painted. It doesn't articulate, but it's just a static minifigure. Nicely painted. Yeah, the head doesn't move or anything. Just for fun, I did grab the Dr. Wu, so you can see how big this thing really is. But there's a nice little quick comparison for you. I'll do again in my full review, so you can see that. Oh, by the way, somebody asked, does he stand up? Yes, he stands up. We'll leave him back here. Here's the instruction book. And the collector's card. Very nice artwork there. And then there's his bio. Not going to read that here. And then his tech specs. Here is the instruction book. And again, I'm not the first one to open this, so I'm guessing Dr. Diecast did take a look at this. Here's that same artwork on the back. Here's the instructions, everything it comes with. Shout out to G. Tony, who gave me the idea to even do this during the unboxings. I know there's a lot of steps. I heard the instructions aren't the best, so hopefully I get to make you guys a nice transformation video here that shows you how to do it. Yeah, and without color, I think it makes it harder. So we'll see. There's the finished alt mode. Very nice. All right, let's move on to the main event here. Here is Ultra Magnus, or Commander Stack. Got this gorgeous metallic gun. That's awesome. I love the way this looks. It's beautiful. You got some alternate faces here. Now they're taped in there, so I'm going to have to remove that tape to get them out of here. I've said this many times before. I always prefer when things come in Ziploc baggies, but I'm okay with this. That's my preference. So you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 faces. And I like that they get the little goatee style option if you want that look. More of a toyish look. All right, let's get the guy out of here, the main event. This. And yeah, right out of the box. It is very impressive looking. It looks like he stepped out of the cartoon, just straight out of the cartoon. And X-Transbots is just always good at that. Oh, this arm is a little stuck. Let's see. Hopefully I don't break this trying to get it into position. It's really... Oh, there we go. Okay. Pretty nice fingers on there. Kind of reminds me of Vans toys, honestly. They're very nicely done. They're tight. Now, this is actually the second version of Ultra Magnus done by Keith. So the first one came out under the KFC product line. This is the X-Transbots product line. But there has been a previous one. So this is the version 2, essentially, from this company. See a little paint chip there. But, man, he is, like, fully painted. You got paint on the thighs, paint on the legs, on the chest. You gotta figure out how these... Assuming he's got ankle tilts. Maybe it's locked. Oh, yeah, it's locked in there. Okay, so you can just unlock those. Pretty tight. I'm going to use a spudger. There we go. I got QC Pass 03. It feels really nice and hefty. Feels very good. Doesn't feel loose and floppy or anything like that. Let's see if I can get this locked in here. Right, looks like that's how it goes. I'm not even sure, honestly. I'll have to figure that out, but it looks like this will lock in here. Although one of them is different, so... Yeah, I'll have to study that a little bit, but... Those look pretty good. These are just plastic. The blue, the red here, the head, the white here, and here, that's all paint, and it looks beautiful. Here's the back. Obviously, one of the cleanest Ultra Magnuses we've ever seen. This backpack is just beautiful. They have all that detail on here, extra detail. Let's articulate a little bit, and then we'll get out of here. I don't want to reveal too much because we're going to look at this in a full review. Nice ratchet joint there on the elbow. You have a soft ratchet on the shoulder. I believe these pull out. Give you a little bit more. Looks like the shoulders go up to there. Yeah, I mean, things feel really good. Really good. Hip skirts got to there. Get this out of the way. Now, someone told me that they have a little issue here. Yeah, see, these just pop right off. So, apparently, this one has the same issue. The issue that... Shout out to Dusty Shells, who hit me up on Instagram. These tend to be kind of loose. And I guess it's due to a little issue here on this hip skirt. There are small hairline fractures. So you just want to be careful with that. They just come off very easily. But move that out of the way. So you got a soft ratchet there on the hip. Seems to hold. Nice. Looks like a double jointed knee. That's pretty cool. That feels good. Yeah, this is the only thing that doesn't feel so great. Those tend to pop off easily. Ankle tilt. Oh, that's on a ratchet. Wow. Back and forth. Yeah, so this feels very, very good. So I'm excited to take a look at this guy. So far, all I can say is it does feel pretty good in hand in the robot mode. Obviously, I haven't transformed it, so I don't know anything about that. But I will be doing that, of course, for the review. So stay tuned for that. And I'll go over into all the accessories and everything like that when we get into the review. So we will see you then.